If you have an autoimmune condition, you need to know this information in this video. I've done other videos on this topic, but you may have not seen them, so I want to do another one specifically on this one point so more and more people can understand the mechanism behind autoimmune diseases. And an autoimmune condition is a condition where your body has developed antibodies against itself. So it's a self-attack. Now, there's a lot of unknowns about autoimmune conditions, but there's definitely something that they know based on a lot of research. And all the data that I talk about is going to be in links down below. And you should definitely research this yourself. There's something called a Th17, which stands for a T helper 17 cell. This is part of your immune system. It's a specialized cell and it does some real interesting things, which we'll get into. But this is what they know about autoimmune conditions. An autoimmune condition is an overactivation of the Th17 cell. Okay, so if that cell is dysregulated and it's working too much, you're at risk for getting rheumatoid arthritis, MS, lupus, psoriasis, and even asthma. Now, asthma typically is not classified as an autoimmune condition, but there's some data that says that it is an autoimmune condition. So it's right in that category. And allergies in general, even though allergies are not an immune condition, involve the T helper 17 cell. And as a side note, HIV involves having an underactivation of the T helper 17 cell. In fact, part of the immune system, specifically the T helper cells, which regulate the entire immune system, is pretty much dysfunctional in HIV. So the problem in autoimmune conditions, the real problem is the chronic inflammation. That's what creates all the collateral damage. And it's caused by your own immune system. So the Th17 cell modulates and prevents autoimmune diseases. And so if you have an overactivation, you're going to have a problem with autoimmune diseases. Now, vitamin D is a direct inhibitor of the Th17 cell, and also they use it as treatment for Th17 mediated diseases. So vitamin D in high doses, I'm talking about at least 40,000 IUs, are essential in autoimmune diseases. Also, there's a lot of data that I'm going to put a link down below that involves with using natural things for decreasing the inflammatory pathways like curcumin, small chain fatty acids. That's when you consume fiber, your microbes make those fatty acids. And also sulforaphane in cruciferous vegetables, all very good for inflammation. And then the fasting mimicking diet. There hasn't been a lot of research on fasting, which I would highly recommend for these conditions, but there is some great data on the fasting mimicking diet, which you're mimicking fasting because you're having a very small amount of calories. So vitamin D, these natural remedies are all very, very important if you have an autoimmune condition. Look up the T helper 17 cell in relationship to vitamin D and some of these other natural remedies, and I think that can really help you.
Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully, in the future, we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.